Miss Harshi, and today I am going to do a very interesting thing. I have 25 questions related to math, so I am going to answer all the questions. In the end, we will get a very good idea about the maths. Okay, let's get started. Okay, first question. What is a noun? A noun is a naming verb that refers to a person, place, thing, animal, quality, idea, virtue. Second question. Give examples for nouns. I will give example for each category. For person category, Stephen, man, children. Places, hospital, New York, police station. Things, book, chair, sandwich. Animals, cat, dog, lion, elephant. Quality, softness, intelligence. Then idea, justice, peace. Action category I will do swimming, cycling, likewise. Third question. Give one characteristic of nouns. Okay. One of the main characteristics of nouns is smaller suffixes. As example, driver teacher, suffix is ear. Then department experiment, suffix is mud. Childhood womanhood, suffix is hood. Then cardiologist, neurologist, suffix is IST. Likewise. Fourth question. What are the main types of nouns? Okay. Mainly, there are 8 types of nouns. Proper noun, common nouns, collective nouns, compound nouns, concrete nouns, abstract nouns, countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Next question. What is proper noun and common noun? Common nouns name generic people, places, things or ideas. Proper nouns name specific people, places, things or ideas. Common nouns name generic people, places, things or idea. Proper nouns name specific people, places, things or idea. Generic, specific. Okay, next question. Give examples for proper noun and common noun. Common noun is car. Under that we can give example. Audi, Wagoner, Vessel. Those names are specific. Those are proper nouns. Then subject. Subject is a common noun. Under that we can give example maths, science, English. Those names are specific. Those are proper nouns. Then languages. Language is a common noun. Under that we can give example English language, Spanish. Those names are specific. Those are proper nouns. Okay. Next question. Does proper noun begin with an English capital letter? Yes. Definitely, proper nouns begin with an English capital letter. Next question. What is collective nouns? A collective noun is a word used to name a group of people, animals, or things. Okay. Next question. What are the common collective nouns used for people? I will give 5 examples for that. A panel of experts. Panel is a collective noun. A board of directors, board is a collective noun. A gang of thieves, gang is a collective noun. A choir of singers, choir is a collective noun. What are the common collective nouns used for animals? An army of ants, army is a collective noun. A herd of deer, herd is a collective noun. A flock of sheep, flock is a collective noun. A pack of wolves, pack is a collective noun. A team of horses, team is a collective noun. Okay. Next question. What are the common collective nouns used for things? A bouquet of flowers. Bouquet is a collective noun. A pack of cards. Pack is a collective noun. A galaxy of stars. Galaxy is a collective noun. Next question. Which type of verb do collective nouns usually have? Collective nouns may be used with singular verb or with a plural verb. If the group members are acting as a single unit, we use singular verb. As example, the crowd was ordered. The group members are acting as single unit. So we use singular verb was. If the group members are acting as individual, we use plural verb. As example, the crowd were clapping, yelling, cheering. Some are clapping, some are cheering, some are yelling. So they are not acting as a single unit. So we use plural verb. Okay, next question. What is compound noun? A compound noun is a singular noun made up of two or more words. Next question. What are the forms for compound nouns? Mainly, there are three forms for compound nouns. As example, hair plus cut equal hair cut. Rain plus forest equal rainforest. Self plus esteem equal self-esteem. Hair cut. Between these two words, there is no space. Rainforest. Between these two words, there is a space. Self-esteem. Between these two words, there is a hyphen mark. So we can identify mainly there are three types of compound nouns: without spaces, with spaces, and with hyphens. Next question. Give examples for each forms. With spaces category, I can give example: ice cream, swimming pool, bus stop, prime minister, living room. Without spaces category: classmate, greenhouse, grasshopper, lifespan, bath. With hyphen category: mother-in-law, son-in-law, babysitter, merry-go-round, self-esteem, likewise. Okay, next question. Compound nouns are made by combining same or different word classes. Is this statement true or false? Explain to us. Definitely, the statement is true. Compound nouns are made by adding different word classes. First one, noun plus noun. As example, bathtub. Bath is a noun, tub is a noun. Second one is adjective plus noun. Full moon. Full is adjective, moon is a noun. Then verb gerund form plus noun. As example, washing machine. Washing is a verb gerund form, machine is a noun. Then noun plus verb. As example, sunrise. Sun is a noun, rise is a verb. Then preposition plus noun. By stand. By is preposition, stand is noun. Preposition plus verb. As example, output. Out is a preposition, put is a verb. Then finally, verb plus preposition. As example, check out. Check is a verb, out is a preposition. Likewise. Right, next question. What is concrete noun? Something you can perceive with one of your five senses are called concrete nouns. Do you know five senses? Our five senses are seeing, hearing, smell, taste, and touch. Something you can perceive with one of your five senses are called concrete nouns. You have examples for concrete nouns. Okay. As example, mountain. Mountain can be seen. Incense stick can be smelled. Crumpet can be heard. Noodles can be tasted. Rain can be touched. So, mountain, incense stick, crumpet, noodles, and rain are the example for the concrete nouns. Right. Let's see next question. What is abstract nouns? Abstract noun is the opposite form of the concrete nouns. Concrete noun is something you can perceive with one of your five senses. Abstract noun is something you cannot perceive with one of your five senses. Okay, next question. Give examples for abstract nouns. Anxiety, fear, pleasure, love, joy. Those emotions and feelings are not tangible. So those are abstract nouns. Next question. What is countable nouns? Countable nouns can be counted. Most nouns in English are countable nouns. We can put a number before the countable noun. As in, we can say one table, two books, 10 coins, likewise. Another main point is they have singular plural form. As example, python, we can pluralize by adding is pythons. Nut, we can pluralize by adding is nuts. Swimmer, we can pluralize by adding is swimmers. So they have singular and plural forms. Okay, next question. In which determiners countable nouns come by which? You will come countable nouns can combine with articles a and an, a born, an animal, and few. Few cats, several, several girls, many students, these players, those women, each students, every teachers, lots of books, like books. Okay. Next question. What is an uncountable noun? Uncountable nouns cannot be counted. We cannot put a number before the uncountable nouns. Also, they have no plural form. We cannot say 3 luggages, 2 papers, 4 furnitures. We cannot say. Okay. Next question. Give examples for uncountable nouns. I can give example. Bread, butter, milk, water, paper. Next question. Is there any way to quantify an uncountable noun? Yes, there is a way to quantify an uncountable noun. We can use measurables or counters to count the uncountable nouns. As an example, 3 pieces of furniture. Pieces is a measurable, furniture is an uncountable noun. 1 box of cereal. Box is a measurable, cereal is an uncountable noun. 1 kilo of sugar. Kilo is a measurable, sugar is an uncountable noun.